temple of El Deir El Bahri, or the mortuary temple of Queen Hatshepsut, a site that has some kind of a feminine touch. It's a combination between the temple ideas and the terrace ideas, built very close to her tomb. Actually, the tomb of Queen Hatshepsut lies directly behind her temple in the Valley of the Kings. On the walls of the temple of Queen Hatshepsut, we have some very interesting stories. One of them is the story of the commercial expedition to the land of Punt or Somalia in modern times. Another very interesting story is the story of the divine birth of Queen Hatshepsut, when she claimed, together with the priests of Amun-Ra, that she was the daughter of God. This is one of the ways she was able to make it to be the king of Upper and Lower Egypt.
The walls of the temple of Hatshepsut, we have many beautiful things have been carved and painted. And it's all about the history of this woman. Few things made it very different than any other temple. One of these scenes is about Hatshepsut moving an obelisk, and actually two obelisks, from Aswan to Luxor. The two obelisks maybe weighed about 600 tons, and she put them end to end on one barge. It is the only record about any obelisk in Egypt from ancient time. And she was so proud that she did it, and that's why she mentioned that on the temple. And that is something very fascinating, that a woman like Queen Hatshepsut was able to run the country in a perfect way, that she was able also at the same time to do all the great things that any other pharaoh did. Hatshepsut wanted to prove on the walls of her temple that she is able to do all the great things that any pharaoh before or after can do. Maybe in the time of Queen Hatshepsut, Egypt was a lot more great than any other pharaoh's time before.